Hope you guys are doing well today, by the way. We are here in Los Angeles, California, getting ready to pick up this dry van, heading all the way up to Eureka, and we'll jump out here and take a look at the truck here in a second once we confirm our load. That's what we want, so we'll go ahead and take that. You can see we are in the Kenworth T680 today. I wanted to get back into this. This is the stock variant. I've not done anything to this other than add the Advantage Aero Kit mod. A link for that will be in the video description, of course, so be sure to check that out. But I've had this mod for a couple weeks now, just have not had a chance to use it yet. But using it today, and it looks pretty good. But I also wanted to get back in the T680 to kind of mess around with some of the steering wheel options. I'm gonna actually go ahead and do that real quick because I have not really done that yet. Adjust the seat here while we're at it. Bring it down just a little bit. That should be good. Let's see. Doesn't seem like it's doing anything, which is weird. Huh. Well, that's kind of strange. Guess we won't worry about that too much. Yeah, that was one of the reasons why I wanted to mess around with the T680 was how you could, tilt and telescope the wheel and all that stuff. I guess we'll just have to sort that out a little bit later. Not a big deal. Yeah, the 1.4 update is live now. It's out of open beta and is live. So there's a few mods that I have to go back and update some of my trucks and stuff like that. So that's not too uncommon when there's an update, but what I've found so far that it's not too painful at all to do that. So I will get that done here soon. Let's pull up, straighten it out, and there we go. Just a little bit more there, maybe. There we go. How about that? Didn't peek outside, didn't cheat. Use the mirrors. I do want to adjust that mirror over there, though. Really quick. Yeah, there we go. All right. Let's get headed up to Eureka. Got the in-dash GPS, so I don't have to have the HUD up, so that's kind of nice. Just kind of clears and cleans the screen up from some clutter there a little bit, so. But the 680 is one of my favorite trucks in-game. You know, I know there's only three, so. But just really enjoy driving this thing. Love the dash layout. Overall, a really nice, clean truck. That's just kind of weird coming out of that lot because you gotta hop over or else you're gonna hang up there in the wrong lane. So that's good. But definitely wanted to go with this combo today since I was using the Advantage Aero kit. Wanted to pull an aero trailer to make it all nice and neat and clean and all that good stuff. Gives here, people. Come on. I guess as we build up a little bit of speed, we'll take a quick look at the truck. Man, this looks really good. All eco-friendly and whatnot. Wanted to use a couple different trucks today, but of course, like I said there a second ago, with the 1.4 update being live now, got to go back and get those updated. Was going to use the other Western Star, the Western Star 4900EX, the extended hood variant of that mod, but looks like the author of that mod might have left some files out or didn't quite clean up some of the def files because I kept getting errors and crashes whenever I was trying to use that. So I need to go back and get all that sorted out. That shouldn't be a huge deal. Then I thought about using the W900, but looks like some of the map files changed on that in the update. Not really sure why they do that, but I just got to go back and get all that sorted out. That won't be a huge deal. Just some of my chrome was red for whatever reason. But I have been wanting to get back in the T680. Like I said, just love this truck. Nice, clean looking. And looks really good with the Advantage Aero kit on it. Cruise set here. Go. It's kind of weird how the steering wheel is not tilting like it's supposed to. I don't know if there's like maybe a mod that's conflicting with that. I wouldn't think that there would be. But we'll check that out a little bit later. We won't do it right now, of course. Because we got to get up north. There are a couple other trucks that I do want to get around and work on. Kind of want to do some updates to the W900. Seen on atsmods.lt today that someone released, I'm sorry I forget their name so I apologize for that, but someone released a modular T800, and the thing that really caught my eye with that is it looks like it has a really nice flat top sleeper on it for Kenworth. Yeah, you'll stop. Just got to get over. Son of a gun, what is traffic doing? but it's a real nice flat top sleeper for a Kenworth. I know sometimes some authors of the mods, they'll get over here in the right hand lane because we're probably out of stop at the scale. But some of the authors of the mods, they'll take just like a flat top sleeper off a Peterbilt, which, you know, is nowhere near accurate for the Kenworth, and they'll put that on there and call it a flat top, but it's not really accurate. So I was really, really excited to see someone release an accurate Kenworth flat top sleeper. So I'll be checking that out. Good and slow down there, so that'll make the chips happy. So we shouldn't be too extremely heavy. I don't think this load was all that heavy. Yeah, well, not too bad. 78,000. We'll take it. Really? Guess I popped the clutch a little bit too soon. There we go. Gotta time that just right now for whatever reason. Not sure why that is. Get out there. But it seems like everything is back to good working order with the SKRS, so I'm happy about that. Reached out to them the other day and they pretty much responded immediately, gave me some information, gave me a couple things to try out, and we're good. While I was messing around with it, though, I think I might have pulled one of the wires loose, so I just went ahead and kind of took everything apart and, you know, made sure all the wires and all the connections were all nice and tight so I didn't have further issues, and yeah, we're all good now. Like how these aero trucks, these new aero trucks are laid out in the game, how the cabin is, because, you know, the seats pretty much adjusted perfectly and I can see pretty well out of the mirrors. I got the hood mirror on there. It's really got really good lines of sight. Yeah, I just want to fiddle around with the W900, add that flat top variant to it, and to hopefully here in the next couple weeks, finally get that out to you guys. No, I've say about every episode that I want to get that thing released, and I just keep procrastinating and not getting to it, but we'll get around to it. You know, I got the Utility 3000R released. Sounds like you guys are really enjoying that. So that's a good thing. I know Bora did a really good job of converting that over. Got it scaled to the correct size. You know, when it was in hauling, it was, you know, scaled perfectly, but the trucks changed just a little bit in ATS, so just had to do, he had to do a little bit of work on that, but did a phenomenal job, so big thanks to him for that. Then another thing I want to finally get around to doing is getting a proper 389 in the game. I know there's one out, at least there was one out on the Steam Workshop. I don't know if it still is or not, but I know there's one floating around the community, probably multiple variants of it floating around the community, and that's the Viper 389, which is actually a 379 with 389 headlights on it. But I got some parts to make a proper 389. That's going to be more of a long-term project. Just want to kind of take my time on that and get it right. Don't want to rush it and all that stuff. Just want to take a quick look at... Oh, hey, getting on the road. Take a quick look at the route here. Kind of seems... I bet you we're probably just taking a straight shot up 5. Catch 580. Yeah, this would be a good run for us. Good run. Going 59, so I'm going to kind of push it and see if we get a ticket or not. Imagine we will, but we'll see. It's nice taking these runs, just pretty much go straight up the interstate sometimes, though. Just get out and drive and don't have to worry about making a whole bunch of exits and turns and interchanges and intersections and all that stuff. Oh, we're good, man. All right. Say, typically, anytime I get that cruise set, anything over 58, usually get a ticket. I don't know, but that hood mirror is coming in real handy. I don't like to put them on, you know, stuff like a Peterbilt 379 or a 389 or the W900 or the Western Star. You know, on an aero truck, I think they look okay. I think they look just fine. But on anything else, I think they look kind of gaudy. Hey, 2 for 2. Is that a Mark car? Huh. I just kind of wonder if that's an unmarked cop car. It's kind of weird. Kind of weird. I do like how, though, you can have, at least have a couple different options for the steering wheels now. And I was reading in the patch notes that the steering wheel is like a separate model or something now. I don't know. I got to go back and double check that, but that could be huge. So, you know, that was always one of the challenges in a Holland was, you know, putting in different steering wheels, because usually... You know, anytime you mess with the steering wheel at all, it would mess up the animation and it wouldn't move. It would just be a static, you know, a pure static steering wheel. Good old AI in this game, I tell you what. Seems like it's really bright for some reason. I don't know. Did I miss my freaking turn somewhere? Yes, I did. Dadgummit. That is okay. Let's see here. I guess it's not a huge deal. We could probably just stay, actually, just stay on 5 and then cut over. Yeah, we'll do that. Why don't we do that? We'll just stay on I-5 instead of trying to get turned around and get back on track there. You know, that way we really don't have a whole lot of towns to go through, so we can just go that way. We'll just take a left up there at Reading and hit Eureka that way. That'll be a okie dokie. I was trying to avoid that Jeep back there and just kind of threw me all off. And now it's got it recalculated for us, so we are good to go. But just a couple things I'm working on for you guys. Finally getting around to working on my settings tutorial video. I know a couple of you guys have asked about that. You know, kind of what my settings are, how do I get the game to look the way I get it to look. So we'll go over a couple things that maybe will help you gain some FPS in the game. Maybe run a little bit smoother for you. Sure, some of you guys have heard it. You know, probably a lot of you guys use it. That's a program called NVIDIA Inspector. Kind of give you guys a quick little tutorial on how to use that. Pretty simple. Basically, all it is, it just gives you some more options for the NVIDIA control panel. You know, unfortunately, if you're on AMD, that part of the tutorial won't apply to you. But if you're Team Green, then I think you'll definitely find some use out of that. But it's kind of what I started to do it the other day that I, you know, kind of got to a point where it's like, okay, I want to mess around with some stuff a little bit just to kind of get a better idea and get a better presentation. Get some numbers and all that stuff for you guys. So working on that. Hope to have that up late next week. And of course, want to do another news update video since the 1.4 update is now live out on Steam. And then they update us a little bit as to what's going on with the map rescale. Really, the only thing they really said was they're surprised. It sounds like they're a little bit ahead of schedule, which is pretty promising. You know, they're always kind of vague with their updates and everything. But they said maybe here in the next several weeks they'll be able to do some internal beta testing, which is pretty awesome. Because usually that means the actual beta isn't too far behind that. So definitely keep an eye out on their blog. They gave us some updated screenshots. Everything looked great there. And then of course got to get the SKRS review out. Get the full review out. I know when I first got it, I basically did, you know, kind of an initial impressions, kind of on the fly in a couple of the Stories from the Road episodes. But I want to take some time to do a full review. I don't know, a couple of you guys had asked if there was any way I could, you know, kind of show the camera of me working the SKRS. Unfortunately, I don't have really any way of doing that unless I figure out some way to kind of capture that maybe with my phone. If I can maybe somehow figure out a way to mount it on my desk in a way that's going to capture it good. But I don't mind messing around with that a little bit. Maybe see if I can't get something. Especially if that is something you guys are interested in. Yeah, just really enjoying me back into 680. Definitely want to get my version updated. So it's ready to go for the 1.4 update. Just like that big mid-roof sleeper on there. What I'd really like to have is a very nice T660. That is one of my favorite trucks. Especially the mid-roof variant. Man, I just love those things. Basically all it is, you know, is an aerodynamic W900. But I just love the look of them. Look really sleek, just look really nice and clean. One of the small trucking companies here locally, they got a pretty decent fleet of them, probably about now half a dozen or so. So not, you know, not an extremely large fleet, but got a nice fleet of 660s that are just really, really cool. thought I had read somewhere that they're going to stop making the T660, which is kind of sad. Get in gear there, you bugger. Out here and grab a screenshot real quick before, and we'll grab it up here on the ramp since we've got an exit coming up. Man, grinding them gears. Looks like a good stop to spot. Good spot to stop. Spot. Oh, come on, really? Thank you. There we go. Hopefully that guy didn't photobomb us there. But guys, that's going to wrap it up for today's episode. Thanks for watching. Thanks for hanging out. Thanks for your support. It is greatly appreciated. We are closing in on 500 subs. We are less than 30 away. So thank you guys for that. And thank you guys for your continued support. If you like today's video, just give it a like and a share. This helps me out a bunch, helps the channel grow. And if you're new to the channel and are not already subscribed, please consider doing so now. But guys, I'm going to hop out of here for now. Until the next video, stay safe out there, take care, and we'll be seeing ya. Hey guys, thanks for watching. If you enjoyed this video, please consider subscribing. Also, if you want to follow me over on the Twitters, follow the link down in the video description. And if you're looking for great gaming gear at an affordable price, then be sure to check out my No Scope Gaming Glasses affiliate link, also down in the video description. And lastly, I upload 3 days a week, so be sure to check down below for my various content playlists for any videos you may have missed. Until the next video, stay safe out there, take care, and we'll be seeing you.